How's it, guys? Welcome back to another video. In tonight's editing nights, or basically it's today, it's daylight outside, but just to give you guys a bit of background as to what has happened, and I'm sorry for the shaky footage. I'm still trying to get used to the setup, walking around and stuff. That's basically the reason why I've traded in my 50mm for 30mm. And although this is a crop sensor body, it's still, you know, it's still a bit too up close and personal if I walk around with a gimbal in my hand. So it might be a bit shaky if I move around like that. But Slammed at the Lake actually was an eye-opener for me when it came to, you know, spacing and stuff. And especially for me that don't have a full-frame camera, I basically went in with a 50mm lens, and the other lens I tried to use, but the quality wasn't that sharp and great, the stock kit lens. So I opted for a 30mm f1.4. As you can see, it blurs the background quite nicely and everything. But I basically also got this to walk around more freely with a 50mm. If I had it on, it was like this. Now at least it's like that. The point of this video basically is to do the whole split imaging thing. So Remy and Matt has asked me for some time now to show a bit of a tutorial on how to do split imaging. There has been some other guys that I've met at hookups, and I mean, it's really not a train smash. It's something pretty much straightforward. And yeah, let's get on to that one. I'm going to show you the process how to split images on Photoshop as per request from Matt and Remy. There is some other guys that also asked, but I did not at that time, I did not get their names. We were basically just speaking in a circle, and then obviously in the group also. So I'm going to show you guys how to do a split image on Photoshop. We're going to use Suhail, aka Sumo's Audi A2 as an example. So I'm just going to go on to that, and I'll drop the screens in as we go along. As you can see here, this is the final edit of one of the pics. I mean, you certainly can't dispute the fact that this is a very beautiful wheel on this car. And I kept telling Sumo, like, you know, I can't get over this wheels, man. I can't put my finger on the word to use for it. It's just damn insane. So just want to show you guys how the before image looked like. That was the initial image. So you can see there, it's not that detailed and stuff, but that is the image. What I did here was I've added a bit of dehazing in on one of my granular filters. I usually use that in most of my images. There's a darkened one at the bottom and there's a lightened one. So what you usually do on that one is, to get that type of effect, you do a dehaze and a declarity. You can, from time to time, you can really bump up. I just want to get back to this here. So you can do a bump up in your highlights also. You just grab that thing, come now, and then if you bump up your highlights, it gives it a bit of a more of a haze. It's got a nice dreamy effect. If I remember correctly, Mike Cravat usually uses this a lot in his photos. I mean, he's currently most probably hands down one of the best automotive photographers on the stance automotive scene, if I can call it that at the moment. That man's photos is generally, you know, it's genuinely breathtaking. But anyways, enough of that. Let's just get on to the photo here quickly. So the photos that I'm going to use for this tutorial is, I have, and this is the important part that you also need to take into account, what photos you are using. Be careful what photos you are using. Sometimes I also make the mistake of adding any type of photo in to give it a look, but then at some point it doesn't always complement the fact of how nice it looks like. So in this instance I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 photos that I'm using in this one. So I just want to make sure my Photoshop is open. There we go. Then Matt, I hope you're listening here. You've been bugging me a lot for this process. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select all four of them and then do this thing select now. There we go. And I'm just gonna say edit in Photoshop. So while we wait for that to open, unfortunately I don't have a graphics card, so my processing on these type of stuff is quite hectic, slow, especially on video. So what I did with this photo shoot was I didn't create a preset for it, and I basically forced myself to go the long route because it's a new method I'm trying, and I wanted to make sure I have that rolled into me. So what I usually do is when I try to figure out a new method, I don't create a preset for it because that's easy. It doesn't teach you to keep, it doesn't imprint it into your brain. So I edit each and every photo separately. So I made sure that I imprinted this process into my head for future purposes and don't suckle, you know, going forward on this. So yeah, so what I usually do is, a lot of people have, you know, everybody's got their own method. I've got my specific method and I usually use a, say this photo, that's not edited. It's just a simpler process for me than rather creating another, another new temp profile. Or another new image. So what I do is then I press Ctrl+O, Ctrl+C for copy, and then Ctrl+V for paste. So I make sure I copy each and every photo into that photo. Ctrl+A, Ctrl+C, and Ctrl+V. Ctrl+A, Ctrl+C, Ctrl+V. Then what I do is, and this is now specifically for PC users, the shortcuts. I use the Ctrl+T option, which is transform. Then you first start off by spacing them out. You can start out like that. The other one is you just do basically the same with the rest. And hopefully I am on point with this for the spacing. I don't think we're gonna make it, so I'm gonna make it a bit smaller. Always make sure you line up to the middle. I just wanna resize these ones. That needs to be a bit smaller. There we go. So that looks like, no, that looks like it might fit in. Sometimes there's like a few centimeters over there, but it's not a train smash. I'll show you now what he's done after that. You see now it's a bit too spaced out, so I usually just want to fill up that part there. So let's just see if this works now. It looks like we're gonna run short again, but it's all about finding the perfect spot You know, we can work with this. I'm not gonna, for time purposes, I'm not gonna wiggle around with that now. So then I just use my rectangular marquee tool. Make sure you have the right selection in play. See, I will sometimes cut off some corners there, because if you look at that point there, there is a bit of overlapping here. And then what I do is I crop. So let me just return back to fit on screen, zoom out, deselect. And there you have it. That is as simple as that. And you can't deny the fact that this looks very nice. I think here I can see another space open, so I'm just gonna go to that image and move it, and then shift that one. So I just need to crop again. Let's just crop it like that. This is not just, obviously you'll perfect it when you are busy with it, but for timing purposes I'm just running quickly through it with you guys. And that's it. That's how it basically is. I'll throw some of the final results in at the end. Also, a lot of people has asked, you know, am I shooting with a full frame camera? No, I'm shooting with a crop sensor camera. It's a Sony a6100. It's a crop sensor. So a lot of people believe the fact that if you have a better camera, your photos will come out better. Partially it's true. And just a disclaimer on my half here, I am not a professional photographer. This is just my hobby and I enjoy it. But I do know a thing or two about cameras and editing and those kind of things. So from my perspective, don't knock yourself down if you have a cheap camera. Invest in your lenses. Make sure you get the most out of that camera before you upgrade. Otherwise, you're gonna waste your money. It's gonna take you longer to get up your skill levels again. So don't be, you know, don't lose confidence in your equipment that you have. Work with what you have. If you can't afford the next best thing, like a better camera or something, do not, I mean, a lot of people make this mistake. Do not go put yourself in debt to, you know, to buy a better camera. Make use of what you have. Learn that camera to its max. I mean, I've shot with a 550D for probably 3 or 4 years straight. Before that I had a Nikon D3000. It's only now recently that I have a decent camera. I mean, you guys know I was on a break, but it's only recently now that I won't say it's a decent camera, it's pretty much entry level. It's a Sony a6100. Yes, it's a mirrorless camera. It's something I bought second hand. If you guys want to, you know, trade in your old cameras, go to Camera World in Belleville. Even though it's second hand, it's worth it at the end of the day. I've always seen it this way. It's another man's loss is my treasure. So if you buy a second-hand camera and you can make it your treasure, do it. But do not knock yourself down. Yes, you're going to have, you know, you want that more of a dynamic range on the full-frame cameras and stuff like that. But if you do not learn your current camera, it's pointless to upgrade, because you haven't leveled out your skills to the max on your current setup. That is why I've basically traded in my 50mm, and I mean, I'm still learning again from over now. Every time I put something new on this camera, it helps me get better. So until I have maxed out my skills on my current camera, I won't be upgrading anytime soon to full frame. Not that I can afford it, but It's just a very expensive route to take, considering the fact that there's so much more to learn with your current camera. And by buying a lens like a 30mm or 50mm with a f1.4 stop, that even the f1.8, I mean, I've been shooting Nifty 50 for years, that really puts a different spec on your photos. It's a bit tough to learn at first, because you need to obviously work on your range and everything, but invest in a 50mm f1.8 if you do not have the funds for a 30mm f1.4 or 50mm f1.4. Or if you don't have funds for other lenses, work with what you have. Put more time in on your editing then. I've been having to had to do that for years to, you know, to keep up. But yeah, until the next episode, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Drop some comments down below to let me know what you guys would like to learn next. Like I've mentioned before, I'm not a professional, but I would really like to help the aspiring photographers out there, you know, to up your skill a bit, give a bit of my knowledge over that I've learned over the years. Even though it might not be much or professional, it's something to help you guys with. Anyways, until next time, peace. I'm like Yosemite Sam in the Wild West. I just laugh at them when they wear vests, cause it's headshots on sight. I don't do beef, I just lay it to rest. I'm so hungry, my flow sound malicious. On my journey, I'm chasing my riches. I got so many reasons that I gotta make it, so I wake up and I go pee. I move like I'm the mob in my all black. You ain't down with my squad, you can fall back. If you never seen greatness, then you about to witness, and you gon' know what you should call that. Every song that I've been on is a hit like a ball back. I took some losses, but I got them all back. Been at the bottom and I'm never going back. I'm fully focused and I'm on track. I'm